Rudolf Nureyev, Veronica Tennant, the National Ballet of Canada, in Tchaikovsky's Sleeping Beauty, conducted by George Crumb, produced and directed by Norman Campbell. And here to introduce the ballet is Mr. Rudolf Nureyev.
The world is filled with beautiful sights and sounds. But as far as I am concerned, no sight is more beautiful, no sound more thrilling than Tchaikovsky's Sleeping Beauty. When Tchaikovsky composed the score for the ballet, he was at the height of his career. While he was not so honored in his lifetime, he is now recognized as the greatest Russian composer of his day. The first performance took place on January 2, 1890, in the presence of the Tsar Alexander and his entire court. That was just over 80 years ago. And now you are invited to another performance of Sleeping Beauty. The story is not new. It begins with a scene in the court of King Florestan at the christening of the baby Princess Aurora. Somehow, the master of ceremonies forgot to invite the fairy Carabosse, and as a result of the slight, the fairy predicts that little Aurora will prick her finger one day and die. The good fairy alters the curse and decrees that Aurora will not die but will only fall asleep for 100 years and be awakened by a kiss from a handsome prince. On her 16th birthday, Aurora pricks her finger and falls into a deep sleep. 100 years later, the handsome prince is out hunting in the forest and has a vision of Aurora. He seeks her until he finds her asleep in the palace. He awakens her with a kiss, and the ballet ends with the wedding celebration. That, very simply, is the story of Sleeping Beauty.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
And so the Princess Aurora begins her 100 years of sleep. In a moment, Act Two.
Thank you. Thank you.